What's the future of Asia? Well, it's not all about China, and a lot of it's about connectivity. Those are a few of the key takeaways from a fascinating discussion at ICI's recent general membership meeting.
A lot of the economic development story is about building connections and building connections between different countries. And so it's about connectivity, and it's about Asians helping Asians, and about Asians following a similar development model multiple years along, right? So the interesting thing is, even as somebody who invested for a long time in Asia, in Japan and the Asian Tigers and China back in 1992, is the whole story of how we're not in the first leg of Asian development, we're actually in the third leg of Asian development, with Japan coming first, some of the more developed, the Asian Tigers, you know, the Koreas, the Hong Kongs, and the Singapores coming second. China is the third act of that. And that there is also a coming fourth act, which is all of the other countries together. So the Thailands and the Indias and the Pakistans, Malaysias, et cetera, where you're beginning to see the growth and where you're beginning to see not just Chinese companies investing overseas, but Western companies going there. And then more importantly, the other developed Asian companies from those countries, like Japanese companies, Korean companies, investing in growth in Thailand and other parts of those new Asian economies.
When you look about at that region in the aggregate, the numbers become pretty stunning.
If you look at the population in aggregate for Asia, 5 billion people, this is more than 50% of the people in the world. And when you knit all those countries and economies together, you're talking about 40% of global GDP today. And depending on how you want to look at this, the size of not just China in the middle of the region, but the size of all of the other large Asian economies around them, significant.